morning, children. So, all of you read the story? Yes. So, what is the story? Yes, it is the story about how only owl gets an egg and returns it to its owner. So, which are the main characters in the story? Only owl, Manty Mall, Tammy Tot, Barry Bircher, and Irma Eagle. So, today let's discuss question answer from the textbook and one more textual exercise, that is speaking section. So let's discuss question answer from the chapter.
Question answer from the page number 5. Here you can see answer in detail and think and answer. Think and answer section, no need to study for the exam, just understand the question answer. But you have to study the answer in detail for the exam. So, the first question, who spotted the egg first? Name the animals that said the egg belonged to them. Who spotted the egg first? Name the animals that said the egg belonged to them. So, who spotted the egg first? Yes, only owl. And which are the animals that said the egg belonged to them? Yes, Manty Mall, Tammy Tot, and Barry Bircher. So the answer is only owl spotted the egg first. Manty Mall, Tammy Tot, and Barry Bircher said that it was their egg. And the second question, why did the animals get frightened? Why did the animals get frightened? Why? Yes, the animals got frightened because there was a crack in the egg and noise coming out of the egg. The animals got frightened because there was a crack in the egg and noise coming out of the egg. And the third question, no, this is not your egg. Who said this? And to whom? No, this is not your egg. Who said this? And to whom? Who said this? Yes, all the other animals in the woods said this to Bircher. So, the answer is all the animals in the woods said this to Bircher. Fourth question, don't touch that egg. This is my egg. Who said this? Don't touch that egg. This is my egg. Who said this? Yes, Irma Eagle. So, the answer is Irma Eagle said this to all the other animals in the woods. Irma Eagle said this to all the other animals in the woods. Last question. Excellent idea, Oli. Who said this? What was the idea? Why did Oli think of the idea? Here you can see three questions. Excellent idea, Oli. Who said this? Who said this? Yes, Irma Eagle said this to Oli. And second question here. What was the idea? What is the idea? Yes, the idea was that Oli would sit on Irma Eagle's back and carry the baby. The idea was that Oli would sit on Irma Eagle's back and carry the baby. And here third question, why did Oli think of the idea? Yes, Oli thought of this idea because the Irma Eagle could not carry the baby and fly at the same time. So, the last answer for the question, excellent idea, Oli. Who said this? What was the idea? Why did Oli think of the idea? The answer, Irma Eagle said this to Oli. The idea was that Oli would sit on Irma Eagle's back and carry the baby. Oli thought of this idea because the Irma Eagle could not carry the baby and fly at the same time. And here you can see think and answer. It includes two questions. The first one, who is the hero of the story Lost and Found? Why? Who is the hero of the story Lost and Found? Why? Who is the hero? Yes, Oli Owl. So, the answer is Oli Owl is the hero in the story. And why? Yes, He found the egg first and tried to find the owner of the egg. And also he helped Irma Eagle to carry the baby back to her nest. And he is very clever and helpful. Second question, do you think Irma Eagle was worried about her egg and her baby? How do you know? Underline the words from the story that tell you that. So, do you think Irma Eagle was worried about her egg and her baby? Yes, Irma Eagle was worried about her baby. How do you know that? Just underline the lines from the story. Take page number 3. Here you can see, don't touch that egg. I was flying high above looking for it. And page number 4, you can see, I must get my baby back to my nest. But I don't know how. I can't fly and carry my baby at the same time. These lines, we can identify that Irma Eagle was worried about her egg and her baby. Values from the page number 6. It is Friday afternoon. Everybody has left the classroom. Suraj, Zainab and Manav are the last ones to leave. They find a brand new box of crayons near the teacher's table. Here is what they say. Manav, I will take the box. I lost my crayons yesterday. Zainab, let's hand it over to our class teacher. Suraj, let's just leave it there and not bother about it. So, will you agree with this opinion? Draw a smiley symbol against the good idea and draw sad symbol against the bad idea and give reasons also. Okay, so what we learned from this chapter, if we find something that is not ours, we must find the owner and return it to them or give it to someone who will return it to the owner.
Now let's discuss speaking section from the textbook.
Page number 8, speaking section. It includes how we greet people and say goodbye in different ways at different times of the day. How did the animals say goodbye to the baby eagle? They said, goodbye, baby eagle. Irma could have said, goodbye friends, good night. So, how we wish or greet people and say goodbye in different times. Just imagine you are in the classroom. When your teacher enter into your classroom, how you wish your teacher? Yes, good morning, teacher. So, let's discuss how to greet people and say goodbye at different times of the day. Page number 8, you can see a table. Morning, afternoon, evening, night. How to wish or say goodbye in morning session, afternoon session, evening session and at night. So, in morning session, how we greet people? Yes, hi, hello, good morning. Is it? Yes. So, how to say goodbye? Good day, goodbye, have a nice day, like this. And afternoon session? Yes, the same manner we wish other people or we greet people. Hi, hello, good afternoon. And we can say goodbye, good day, goodbye, have a nice day. And evening section? Hi, hello, good evening. And we can say goodbye, simply goodbye. And at night, hi, hello, good evening, like this we greet people. And how to say goodbye at night? Yes, goodbye and good night. Now I will play an audio. Listen the conversation between Rahul, Deepak and Meera.
Speaking. Listen to this conversation. Rahul and Deepak are waiting near the school. They meet Rahul's aunt, Meera Roy. Rahul wishes his aunt and introduces Deepak to her.
Good evening, Rahul. Are you going home?
Hello, Meera, auntie. Yes, we are waiting for the school bus. This is my friend Deepak. Deepak, this is my aunt, Ms. Meera Roy. She is my mother's sister.
Hello, Deepak. Are you both classmates?
Hello, Ms. Roy. No, I am in class 4 and Rahul is in class 3.
Oh, okay. All right, go home safe, both of you. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Have a nice evening, auntie.
Form groups of 4 role-play this conversation. Nidhi and her father are in a shop. Nidhi's classmate Komal is also there with her father. Nidhi greets Komal. Komal greets Nidhi and introduces her father. Nidhi greets Komal's father and introduces her father. Then the fathers then greet each other and speak 2 sentences. That we all know that we are not in the classroom, so we can't do the role play. So don't worry, try to practice how to say goodbye and how to greet people and make a conversation and make it a role play with your family members.
So hope you all understood the question answer and speaking section. Write down the question answer in your notebook and study very well. We will meet the next class. Till then, take care. Bye.